This distance meter uses ultrasonic sensor to measure distance and shows the result on the 7-segment LED display. Cool thing is that driving the multiplexed LED display and interfacing the ultrasonic sensor happens mostly on hardware, thanks to the configurable digital blocks inside the PSoC microcontroller. Every time the distance has been measured, which happens automatically, I'm just reading it from the buffer and putting it to the registers where the hardware will automatically read it and show it on the display. Before I go through all the details how I made this, I'd like to give update on the microphone preamplifier project and at the same time thank our sponsor PCBWAY.com. I have used their services in multiple sponsored videos before and few times in other instances, and one project was microphone preamplifier shown a couple of videos ago. I got feedback that it was lacking some lower frequencies, and I quickly noticed it was due to the wrong sized capacitor, and I fixed it before sharing the project on PCBWAY's shared projects section. Values on there are the ones I ended up using. I can highly recommend PCBWAY.com for all your prototyping needs. Back to this distance meter project. These HC-SR04 ultrasonic sensors have quite simple interface. User sends high pulse to trigger pin, and after the falling edge, the module sends ultrasonic pulse it uses to measure the distance. Then there will be output pulse on the echo pin, with pulse length being proportional to the measured distance. So the controller needs to output pulse on one pin and measure pulse length on another pin. PSoC chips are programmed in PSoC Creator IDE, which has code editor, but also other features like schematic editor for configuring the hardware. This part of schematic shows the controller for the mentioned ultrasonic sensor interface. I have 6 Hz clock connected to a toggle flip-flop. This will output 3 Hz signal that is used to trigger the sensor 3 times per second. That same signal will also reload the timer, preparing it for the next input pulse. The timer counter component is configured to count clock cycles between rising and falling edge of the input signal, coming from the sensor's echo pin. I have configured timer's clock to be 17.25 kHz, which I have calculated based on the HC-SR04's pulse length equation. This clock speed gives approximately 1 cycle per centimeter. Timer starts counting up from 0 when input goes high, and every clock cycle increases it by 1. When input goes low, counter value is captured and it will indicate distance in centimeters without need for any calculations. This is how I have configured the timer and its input modes. Start, stop and capture are all connected to the sensor's echo pin. By setting the modes and interrupt settings correctly, this timer will measure the pulse length and trigger interrupt once the pulse is detected. Next I need to add the display, so I could see the measured values. I have these 4-digit 7-segment displays I've ordered from AliExpress. These are common cathode type, meaning they're separate pin for 7 segments and 1 decimal point. Those are shared by all the digits, and each digit has their own cathode pin. Driving these happens by driving all the segment pins high that needs to be on first digit and driving the first cathode pin low. Then same for second numbers, segments and second cathode pin. Then third, then fourth. So only one digit is lit at any given time. This is repeated fast enough for a human eye to think they are constantly on. Usually this requires some kind of while loop or timer-driven interrupt that switches between digits. Second part of schematic is for driving the display. Like I said, segments to be turned on are controlled one digit at a time. I have 4 control registers where I can write values programmatically, and those values will control the output pins of that component. There's 1 control register for each digit, and I have configured these to be 8 bits wide, so there's 1 bit for each segment and decimal point. Then to write only one of these outputs to actual GPIO pins, I'm using multiplexer component, with number of input terminals matching the digit count and terminal width matching the width of those control registers. Output of that multiplexer is connected to 8 GPIO pins. To control the multiplexer, Selecting which control resistor is connected to the output, I have two bitwise counters connected to each control pins. I have set counter's input clock to be 400 Hz, which means active digit will change 400 times per second. And with 4 digits, it means each digit will be turned on and off 100 times a second. That is fast enough to not cause significant flicker. Then to cycle through cathode pins, synchronized with the previously described segment pins, I have that same counter's output pins connected to a de-multiplexer, which connects active high signal to one of four outputs. These outputs are connected to base of external n-channel MOSFETs, which will pull corresponding cathode pins to ground when base is high. This will cycle through all four outputs synchronized with the multiplexer, and that will result in showing correct number or character incorrect digit of the display. So far, I have done most of the tasks this distance meter needs to do, and I haven't even opened the code editor yet. In the code, I start the timer used to measure the pulse coming from the sensor, and give the interrupt component the function name for interrupt service routine. In the interrupt service routine, I read the captured value of the timer, and write value of each digit to correct control register. Values I'm writing aren't the actual numbers, but the bytes describing active segments of that number. This function is repeated for every new pulse coming from sensor's echo pin. Everything else that happens while this device is running happens in hardware. That is why I love these PSoC chips. In my opinion, this was perfect example of project that these PSoCs are a good option for. I'm not saying this is something that normal microcontroller couldn't do, but it's nice to have all the processing power for other tasks. I hope this was useful, inspirational, or interesting. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.